What is going on, guys? We are back with the deciding game between Bushdish and Sidumas. Whoever wins this stays in OLT, and yet a loser will be out of OLT. So we're gonna look at the teams. We already know Sidumas' team because he used it yesterday versus Vertex. So we know this is a Scarf, Tabo Lele, Choice Bennett, Tyranitar, Spikes, Ferrothorn, Rocks Lando. I think it's defensive. And then he has these two other bulky blobs at the end. I don't know why I called this a blob. Blob is probably the wrong term for them, whatever. But basically, Reuniclus is going to be annoying for Bushdush. It always comes in on the Mew for free. Toxapex is going to be even more annoying. Like, how does he even kill Toxapex? Look at Bushdush's team. Like, yeah, he has Lando, but this Lando should be Scarf. Let me tell you why it should be Scarf. He has this, this, and this. They can all check Zygarde. The main reason you run defensive Lando is for Zygarde. And, yeah, what else? Roxtran. Potential SD Scizor with default Mew, but if it's default Mew, that means it would get poisoned by Toxic Spikes eventually. Toxic Spike has more PP than Defog, so it goes up anyway. Even if the Mew comes hard in on Toxic Spikes and then Defog. I don't see how Bushdush wins this. Like, he cannot really kill Toxapex that well. Unless he's like a heavily special attack invested teacher in Magma Storm and Earth Power. That would be another option that he had. Also, he doesn't have good switch-ins to Bennett Tyranitar. So, like, I see this matchup is heavily... Like, looking at matchup, it's heavily in Sejuma's favor. And the Greninja, I don't know if it's Ash or Protean, but it shouldn't be Scarf. The Lando should be Scarfed. The trend is obviously Rocks, if I didn't say that already. Assault vs. Tangrowth with knockoff. But, like, if he knocks off, like, he can knock off maybe Black Slash on the Pex. But, like, that's it. Like, Pex still doesn't die. It has Regenerate and Recover. Just because you knock it off doesn't mean it dies. Yeah, Sidumas himself doesn't have Hazard Control, but I talked about this yesterday. He's just gonna overwhelm, like, he's just gonna overwhelm Bushdush with Hazards. Spikes, Toxic Spikes, and Rocks, and yeah, Bushdush is gonna be forced to defog. Yeah. Scizor also doesn't do shit in this game when he has Toxapex, and Lele also gets up Psychic Terrain, that means Bullet Punch doesn't work. And yeah, what else? That's pretty much it. I'm just waiting for them to pick a lead now. I don't know why it's so long a team preview, good god. I don't remember that a game that I recorded where the team preview has been on for so long. So these are what Greninja was Toxapex. So CG was realizing immediately that he has a hard time dealing with this Toxapex. He can get up a Toxic Spike turn one here. And it's gonna, like, the pain is gonna start for Bush, like, Bushdush. If his default Mew is gonna get poisoned unless he goes hard into it. He could still be Defog Scizor, but I think he's like SD Scizor because his team is like kinda lacking a win condition otherwise. So I assume he's gonna get up the Rocks here with his Heatran, but like, that's the banter. And he can just fire off a Stone Edge. I mean, he can pursue this breaking a switch, but looking at Bushdush's team, he doesn't have a switch in. Even if it's defensive Scizor before it's Mega Evolved, it doesn't switch in well to Stone Edge. So he does stay in and goes for Will-O-Wisp. That is really interesting, Heatran set. I'm surprised by that the Heatran is slower, which is really odd. Like, what? Most trends these gen max speed. And even ABR said in the chat how is the Risk Translord and Bantar. So this now Bushdush at least doesn't have to worry about the Bantar anymore because it's burned. Goes into his Landorus here, that's most likely Scarf. Bushdush can fire off HP Ice here. Sidumas is gonna go for Rocks here. Sidumas is gonna start Hazard stacking. So Bushdush is forced to defog. And if Bushdush for some reason doesn't have defog, he's just gonna get destroyed by Hazards. But he should have defog on the Scizor or the Mew. And yeah, T-Spike up also means that Scarf Lele is even more annoying. Rocks plus T-Spike, like, he doesn't switch in well into Scarf Lele. That actually did a fuck ton, I don't know. Like, maybe this Lando has some special attack investment. It's definitely not money special attack nature, it's probably money speed death on the Lando, on the Bushdush side. I think this is a Helm Lando, if I recall correctly from yesterday. But it took so much that it seems like it's an offensive Lando, but yesterday it was a defensive one, like, unless I'm tripping. Pretty sure it was defensive. It could have obviously changed it, but like, defensive Lando just makes sense on this team if you look at it. So yeah, now this is locked into him, Paw Ice, Scarf, most likely. Like, that means Sidumas has a lot of options here. He can go into Toxapex, he can go into Ferrothorn, he can go into Reuniclus, he has so many options here. And Buster's strength is already super low. That means Ferrothorn is also gonna become annoying. Like, just Sijuma's, these 4 months are gonna be so annoying for Buster's. Like, how do you even kill them, my man? Because with Teeth back up, Tangrowth doesn't come in that well on Ferrothorn. Tangrowth is the only one that blocks Leech Seed. There's the Leech Seed, and Sijuma is almost dead now. So obviously this is threatened out by a potential fire move. So I'm expecting him to maybe sack off his T-Tar. Because if he goes in a Toxapex here, he could get blown away by, if this is modest, Magma Storm into Earth Power. He should Rocks and Wisp, right? So it should be Earth Power and then Fire Move in the other two slots. Because how else does he kill Toxapex if this doesn't have Earth Power plus Magma Storm? I guess he could have Psychic on Mew. But still, like, Psychic on Mew, Psychic from Mew, from Defensive Mew. Like, unless he's Offensive Mew, but if he's Defensive Mew, Psychic doesn't even do that much to Pex. It does, like, maybe a bit more than half. That's just a head calc. See, that wasn't the Scizor, I'm not sure what he predicted there. Scizor has to now fear a hidden power fire from this Tapu Lele. Sijuma can also predict the Scizor to switch. Even if Scizor stays in, it's not the end of the world for Sijuma. Like, Trion would come in for quote-unquote free, it still has to take rocks and it's almost dead, but quote-unquote on free, comes in for free on HP Fire. That's the reason why Sijuma might go for, like, a different move. I can see him going for, like, a Psychic here or a Moonblast. And Moonblast does more to the Mew, I guess. Mm-hmm. And overall hits everything because Greninja obviously is immune to Psychic, but that wouldn't be the end of the world if he goes to Greninja or Mew, so I feel like Psychic or Moon is fine as well here. So he goes on the Heatran expecting hidden power fire, he lives on 1% but he dies, so Sijuma goes for Moonblast, so anticipated the Mew, or I guess the Grand Mew, something like that. But like I said, Psychic would have been fine as well, would have done more to Scizor in case Buster stayed in, and Greninja and Mew both get poison and take rocks if they come in, so that was, like, I feel like Psychic was fine there, because it does, like, more to the Tangrowth. But it was, I guess it was kind of obvious that he was gonna go Trend there. He was hoping for the HP Fire, and Sijuma just had to go for a move that is not HP Fire, and then the Trend was pretty much, not pretty much, the Trend was dead then. Because if he didn't go for HP Fire there, if he hadn't went for HP Fire there, the Trend would have gone lefties, and then he would have to switch out, and he would have gone lefties again. That means the Trend could have been able, would have been able to take another rock hit later on, like, would have been able to come in on rocks again. But yeah, Buster didn't default yet. These T-Specs are gonna fuck him up, good god. Yeah, Buster is forced to Earthquake here because this Lele is a problem for him. Sijuma might just sack his Lando here. I don't remember how healthy his Lando is. I think it's, is it in range to die from rocks? It's pretty low, that's all I remember. So yeah, he's just gonna Earthquake. He's able to take a Moonblast. He kills the Lele here. There might have been a roll, not 100% sure. Is that even Scarf Lando? I thought Scarf Lando doesn't even kill Lele from there. I thought it only does like 80. So maybe there was a high roll, or this Lando isn't Scarf and I'm missing something. And he's an attack boosting item. But I think there's a Scarf, right? So he goes in Reuniclus. And how does Bushtrush kill this Reuniclus? I guess he's forced into Scizor. Yeah, he's forced into Scizor. Bushtrush can double into Toxapex, but he doesn't have to. Like, Bushtrush, did I say Bushtrush? I meant Sijuma. Sijuma is in such a good position, like, he doesn't have to predict. He lost his Lele, but he didn't need his Lele. Like, yes, Lele would have been nice to have, but it's not necessary to win. When Reuniclus and Toxapex just annoy the shit out of Bushtrush, like, those 2 months alone kind of just win. So Bushtrush is gonna roost here. Sijuma is obviously not gonna stay in, he's just gonna go into Toxapex, or Pharaoh, okay, I thought he would go Pex. So what I'm getting from this is he's gonna fire off a Spike or a Leech Seed. So it's SD Scizor, so that means it's not defog. So the only potential defogger left is Mew, okay. So I assume we're gonna see a knockoff come out here. Oh, it's SD U-turn. Oh, so SD U-turn, Bullet Punch, Roost. So that means Toxapex walls it completely. If it had knockoff, it could have done good damage to Toxapex. And yeah, now what does he go to? Probably Landorus here, but Landorus has to keep taking rocks, so it cannot do that forever. And Toxapex has Regenerator, so it's basically at full after Black Sludge plus Regen. Oh, not at full, but almost at full. No, I think it's still at full. Lefty's healed 6%, right? Or Black Sludge healed 6%. Yeah, I think so. Mm-hmm. So it's pretty much at full. He only has to take rocks every time it comes. He comes in, but Toxapex just doesn't care too much about rocks. Like, the only way you pressure Pex with a team like this is if you have rocks plus spikes up. As oh, my computer is lagging a bit there. I hope it will go away a few. So I guess he's gonna go for a Dark Pulse Flinch, or he might bluff the extra sensory here. So I expect Sijumas to maybe sack off his Tyranitar here, or sack off his Landorus. Because then he would that gives him information about the Greninja set, and if he goes Tita, he would also get Sandstorm chip on this. I mean, the Tita is burned, so it's not gonna be doing too much. The Lando is low, it's not gonna be doing too much. So sacking one of the two, it's definitely the play to make here. You don't want to risk your Toxapex here. You don't know the Greninja set yet. I know that I think you can tell from the gender if a Greninja is probably no Ash, but I forgot which gender means what. And I honestly think it's way more interesting to try and figure out the Greninja set from team preview, or like in general thinking about it, not just knowing it from gender. But it's obviously smart if you know the if it's Ash or not from the gender. So I have to look into that in the future. He goes Ferrothorn, and we do see it's Spikes Ash, Battlebond Greninja is what I meant, yeah. So Sijumas got information there. I still feel like, yeah, Ferrothorn was a fine play, but like sacking Tita or Lando would have also been fine. But not that it matters too much. It's not like he was gonna go for Hidden Power Fire that turn. And yeah, now Sijumas gets up Spikes as well. Sijumas has Spikes, Rocks, and Toxic Spikes up. And yeah, there's no Toxic Spike on his side. Even if there were, he had a Toxapex. But if Bushtrash had a Toxapex, this makes a huge difference in this game. Because Bushtrash having Pex meant that he could have absorbed the opposing T-Spikes. So that actually, like, he's gonna get overwhelmed. Yeah, now he knocked off the Black Sludge. Wow, what does it matter? Like, what? This Pex can just go for a recover here, or like, it doesn't matter what the Pex does. It's just not gonna die. Earthquake is gonna do negative damage from Tangrowth. Tangrowth has to take the hazards every time it comes in. I mean, yeah, Pex takes hazards as well, but Pex doesn't take poison, which is like, this is the one huge advantage that Sijumas has. And on top of that, Bushtrash, like I said earlier, doesn't have anything to kill Pex. Now he goes Mew, he takes hazards. We do see it's Lefty's Mew, so it's out of the picture that it's potentially offensive Z-move Mew. And you can just go into Reuniclus for free here. Like, Sijumas doesn't lose anything. And yeah, Reuniclus also, oh, he goes Tita. That's fine as well. So that cancels out the Lefties, and that means poison does more. So he goes for Roar. Which means that Bushtrash probably doesn't have Defog. Roar, Softball, Wisp, Ice Beam, I assume. What? So he doesn't have Defog, so he's just gonna get fucked up by these spikes. So, I mean, this game was in Sijuma's favor, even if he had Defog. But not having Defog means he's just pretty much done. But the game would have been a bit longer if he had Defog, but I don't think it mattered. Like, Sijuma's is like pretty much in control of this game. Yeah, if Bushtrash had his own packs, he would have been here for a while, because then he could have absorbed T-Spikes, and both players would not really get up T-Spikes because of the packs on both sides that could absorb the T-Spikes, and he would just be here forever. And yeah, even then, if Sijumas had Speed Creep on his Reuniclus for opposing Toxapex, even then he would still be able to pull through with that. I think if he like comments into Psysharks and weakens that, and also he might have been he should have if Bushtrash had a Pex, it would be a different story. Then maybe he should have kept the Lily around because Psychic Terrain obviously boosts up Reuniclus as well. But yeah, Tangrowth is almost dead here. I assume Bushtrash is gonna, like, Bushtrash doesn't even have a good pivot here, to be honest. Let's talk about the game again, not what if he had a Pex, because he doesn't have one. Like, Mew gets completely destroyed here if he switches out to keep this by hazards and everything. Like, he doesn't have good switch-ins. Sijumas has a free recover or skull here. Probably recover, because if Bushtrash stays in the Earthquake, your Pex is quite low if you don't heal. So yeah, he's gonna recover here. And Bushtrash can choose if he wants to switch and tank hazards with something, or if he wants to Earthquake and sack this. Okay, he switches into Pharaoh, okay. So if he knocked, then he at least got rid of the Lefties here on the Pharaoh. I think the Lefties are still there, yeah. The Earthquake. Tangrowth is dead, and yeah, this is just gonna be, it's gonna take a few minutes, but Bushtush doesn't win this game at all. Like, nobody notices those walls from Toxapex. Mew also doesn't really put any offensive pressure as walled by Pex and by Reuniclus. And the Burn Off helps Ferrothorn. This is a free Leech Seed or a free Toxapex. It doesn't really matter, he can choose. Greninja is Ash, so it's also not the biggest problem for Sijumas. If it ever gets a flinch on one of these two, he can just then sack something. Because Ash is pretty much dead from all hazards and poison, and then if he sacks something, it's probably gonna die to sand plus poison. If it doesn't die already to all these hazards anyway. Like, if Gwen stays into on the pecs ever and tries to flinch it, it gets like destroyed by poison, all the hazards. Like, look at this, Gwen comes in and it's so fucking low, like, look at this. So, like, even if he gets the flinch, then he gets to, like, super low, and then he can switch out, and then he dies to poison. So he's not even gonna get Ash ever. And yeah, Sijuma switching out in a tar makes a smart play, expecting a dark pulse. I mean, he can spike here, but not that it makes a difference. Oh, he can go for Z-moves. Is it Hyper Vortex? Oh, it's Black Hole Eclipse. So Sijuma looking like a god. So Bushtush was trying to kill the Pex. So I guess Black Hole Eclipse is like a somewhat of a lure for Pex, but not really, because I think it doesn't even do half. Like, I should run the calc, but I assume it only does like 40-ish to Spidef Pex, maybe 45. But I think it doesn't even do that much. Like, that's definitely not the best lure to Spidef Pex, like, or like Pex in general. So yeah, Sijumas can sack this, or you can go into Toxapex. Not that it matters. Bushtush is kind of forced to go for Roost here. But the game just ends between Reuniclus and Toxapex. He just walls everything. I've said this multiple times. And my voice is kind of coming to an end. But yeah, it's fine. He's just gonna eventually get the burn. Even if he doesn't get the burn, it doesn't matter. He only has Bullet Punch and U-Turn. Both are resisted by the Pex. You know, he starts scalding. Does he get the burn? He gets it pretty early. So yeah, if I was Bushtush here, I would probably just forfeit. I do understand that he wants to keep playing, but because it's ulti round 4 and he fought for this and everything, and it's a tour and you don't want to just give up, but like, literally has no win con at this point. His win con is like Sijuma's internet dying, I guess. Like, what? Yeah. I mean, I know, especially on the ladder where you have games like this, I completely understand if you don't forfeit sometimes, because opponents like to choke, especially on the ladder. I've had games where like I couldn't win, but I just kept playing and then my opponent choked. Like, if you're patient, you can like bring some games back, but this is a tournament game, and like Sijumas is not gonna choke. He's speeding it up a bit by getting rid of the lefties and the Mew, and the Mew just doesn't have... It's gonna die to Leech Seed and Poison here, I think, right? It just doesn't have Defog. But like I said, even if you had Defog, it didn't change the outcome of the game. It would have just dragged it out. Lando, that was Lando's last switch into rocks. Look at all these heads. It looks so nasty. So he sacks off the Lando to scout what he locks himself into. He locks into Earthquake. So he can just go Reuniclus here, click Psyshock or Psychic, whatever he had. He had Psyshock. He showed it earlier already. So yeah, Scizor is the only one left. And Scizor cannot win, even if he somehow gets to plus 6. Like, if Sijumas fucks up, he's still burned, and even then he doesn't do enough damage to the Pex. Like, I think plus 2 burned U-turn will probably do like 0 to Pex still. Like, maybe 10%, I don't know how much it would do. Maybe a bit more, yeah, a bit more probably. But yeah, Sijumas can spam whatever he wants. He can spam Haze, he can spam Toxic Spikes if he doesn't want to waste Scald BP. He can also spam Scald though. It's not like he needs the Scald BP for anything else. Yeah, he can just spam Scald to weaken the Scizor with the burn a bit faster. And if Bushtush keeps playing, then he has all his, like, he has his Roost left, so it's gonna take a while. He plays this out because Bullet Punch has 48 PP and Roost has like still a lot left. Like, I don't know how many use. I think he used like 2 Roosts only so far, but I haven't really been counting. But yeah, I mean, I think I can just pause it and skip to the end because it's pretty obvious that the game is over. So like, he tries to SDR. Yeah, we can say it already. He has a T-spike there. He just doesn't want... It doesn't matter what he does. Like, he can literally click Haze Recover or Scald or whatever. Or he can even switch around and then... Like, he can even switch around, sack his Reuni and his Pharaoh, and then at the end Pex will win anyway. The only way Sijumas could lose this game, maybe, if he clicks if he sacks his other two mons and then goes back in the Toxapex, let's push the SD up to +6 and then doesn't click the right move. Like if he only clicks Toxic Spikes, if he doesn't click Hazos, I guess then he could potentially lose. Like, believe, like he's obviously not gonna do that, but that would be like the only way I see, and even then I don't know if he would even lose. Like this is just unlosable. But yeah, let's talk about I really wanted to start streaming, but yeah, it turned out my internet was too bad when I did the test stream the other week. Like at first I thought the lag was because of my computer. I think I talked about this once in a video. You guys can watch the game in the back, it's pretty much over. And yeah, we can already say congrats to CJMus for moving on, because he's not bringing this back. Yeah, I wanted to stream for you guys. What I wanted to stream, some of the tour games and yeah, some Showdown Live, some Pokemon Insurgents Let's Play. But yeah, it doesn't work because of my bad net. I fixed the issues with my OBS, so like that wasn't a problem. It's just my internet. So yeah, I'm not sure what I'm gonna do about this, because I would really like to start streaming. I'm probably not gonna get faster internet anytime soon. Well, like I did a test stream for like 2 hours and my voice is pretty dead after the 2 hour stream. Then I rewatched it and it was a bit laggy because of my net. Like it's not super laggy, but it's just not the best when it's like every few seconds it lags a bit. So yeah, I mean you could just click Scald, it speeds it up a little bit. Not that it matters. So yeah, CJMus is gonna take the win over Bush Tush. The other games left, there was the year game yesterday with Sutrest. There are like 6 other games, I think. 2 in losers bracket and 4 in winners bracket. I think Floppy versus Ojama is in losers bracket, Floppy aka Georgie. I think they're playing on weekend. What other games are left? Winners bracket has, I think, Googly versus... I forgot. Terrence Smith is playing Black Oblivion, that's what I know in winner's bracket. Who's Googly playing again? I forgot. I think Sabella. Who else is in it? Yeah, so he finally forfeit. CJMus wins. Congrats to CJMus. I'm just trying to think who else is in the winner's bracket. I think Extra Shine, but I forgot his opponent. Oh, I think Empo is still in it. I forgot who Empo. I don't know if Empo is playing Extra. I think Extra is playing someone else. But yeah, you guys can expect most of the series live. Hopefully, I will catch them all. And yeah, I have a lot more Snake True games. I know it's Phase Snake Phase 2 is up, but I have Snake Phase 1 games that I will still upload over the next days. What else? I wish you guys a fantastic day. Hope you all enjoyed. And yeah, good job CJMus, congrats for moving on. And yeah, still a good run for Bush Tush. Like round 4 is not, like he still slayed ABR, I think. Yeah, he beat him last round. Like he's kind of like the ABR slayer. He beat him like in a few different tours. He beat him ulti last year, I think, too. But yeah, thank you guys for watching. Have a fantastic day. Smash the like button if you want to see more. And peace out, Bob.